Hi, I'm Rami Tamimi. Today, I'm going to explain the different type of lines that you can use in AutoCAD Civil 3D. Now, there are four different types of lines that you can use. There are just lines, there are polylines, there are 3D polylines, and there are feature lines. Let's take a look at how to use all four of these. To begin, we're gonna start by drawing a line. To do this, you're gonna press the L key on your keyboard to select line. You can also go up to the ribbon under the Home tab, come over to Draw and select Create Line. And I'm gonna go ahead and draw in a bunch of lines. It's important to note that lines are drawn in at individual segments. Therefore, they're not connected together. Each one of them is its own feature. Lines are pretty limited in terms of what kind of attributes they have. The only thing you can really control is the location of the two vertices of the line. This does include elevation. I'm gonna draw one line. And when I look at my properties, I have a start Z, which is the starting elevation of the first vertice. Let's make this 10. I also have an end Z, which is the elevation at the second vertice. Let's make this 20. If we take a look at the view from the front, we can see that along the X and Z axis, the line is going up. Now, if I were to change the elevation of Z to 0, now the line is going down. So you're able to control the elevation of both of the vertices on the line. The next type of line that we're gonna look at is a polyline. To draw a polyline, type in PL on your computer, or you can select this icon in the draw menu. And you can do the same thing, draw a bunch of lines. The main difference between a polyline and a line is that all of the lines are connected. They are all one feature, and moving one vertice affects multiple lines. In the properties menu, you can choose to close this polyline to create a polygon. At every single vertice, you have the option of adding an additional vertice to change the geometry of your polyline. You can also remove this vertice, or you can just choose to stretch it and move it. In the middle between the vertices, you have the option of stretching the line inside of the polyline. You can also add a new vertice if you wanted. You want to convert the line into an arc, you can convert this line and create an arc-like shape within the polyline. This is really useful when you're trying to trace some kind of image. If you have a sidewalk that you wanted to show the lines to, you can create arcs within your polyline. The limitations of the polyline is that the entire line is under one elevation. You can't have multiple elevations at multiple widths. This is because it's considered a 2D line. It doesn't have any kind of depth to it. You can raise it and lower it as a uniform line, but you can't assign each individual vertice an elevation. That's because in order to do that, you need to use a 3D polyline. To draw a 3D polyline, type in 3D. And then you're able to just draw in your 3D polyline. Now, the main difference between a 3D polyline and a regular polyline is the fact that you can add elevations to your vertices. By selecting the line, you can come over to the geometry section and select the vertice that you want. So we're on vertice 1. Let's make the elevation 10. If we move to the second vertice, we can make this elevation 20. The third vertice, let's make it 25, and the fourth vertice, let's make it 15. Now if we change over to the front view, we can see along the X and Z axis, the line goes up a little, it goes up a little bit more, and then it starts to drop down, just like we indicated in our properties. Now the last type of line that you can use is a featured line. Feature line is only exclusive to Civil 3D, so you can't use it on traditional AutoCAD. The main difference between featured lines and 3D polylines is that featured lines give you the ability to design with the line. This is great if you're trying to create a profile or if you're doing some kind of pipe networking. The feature line has more sophisticated functions that allow you to edit the line in order to fit your design. Let me show you what I'm talking about. I find the easiest way to draw a featured line is to start with a polyline. So we're gonna start with a polyline, we're gonna draw it in. Under the Create Design section, you're gonna click on Feature Line, Create Feature Lines from Objects. Select your polyline and hit Enter. Hit OK, and now we have a feature line. You see this new Featured Line tab opens up and you have all these functions that you can use your feature line with. The one that I'm gonna show you today in this video is the Elevation Editor. With a feature line, you're going to be given your stationing at every vertice. You can then manually input the elevations, the length of every segment, and that will calculate the back grade and front grade. So let's make the elevations here. 10, 20, 5, 15, and you can see we're grading 10.93 feet to go up to the next station. To go back, you have to go 10.93, then up another 5, and then to go back down, it looks like negative 9.58. And you see the design then comes in for our featured line. I'll click OK. And the same thing here, when I go down, you can see the elevation spiking up right away, then gradually going up, and gradually coming down, then spiking back down. So these are the different types of lines that we use. As you can see, it's kind of like a class system. A normal line is at the lowest end, you know, where it's very basic and you don't have a lot of flexibility with it. A polyline allows you to have more flexibility by having multiple segments. A 3D polyline allows you to add elevations to your vertices, and a feature line gives you a wider range of design features that you didn't have with 3D polyline. Now you can upgrade your line to different classes or downgrade your lines. Let me show you how to do that. Let's say I have a bunch of lines drawn in. Now each one of these lines is its own separate feature. If I wanted all these lines to be a polyline, I can click J on my keyboard and that will use the join command. Now I have a polyline. If I wanted this polyline to become a 3D polyline, I could go into the modify tab in the ribbon under the design section, convert 2D to 3D polylines. And now my polyline is a 3D polyline. You could just type in this command, although I feel like it's a bit cumbersome. That's why I'd rather just click on it. And I showed you guys how to create a featured line. Feature line, create from objects. Okay, and now you have a feature line. Now, let me show you how to downgrade your lines. With this feature line, if I wanted to downgrade it to a 3D polyline, I'm going to use the command explode by pressing X on my keyboard. Now, I have a 3D polyline. And if I wanted to explode my 3D polyline into a bunch of lines, I would just repeat the command, explode. Now I have a bunch of lines. And that's how you can upgrade and downgrade your lines. All right, now let's use these lines to create line work for a real project that we're working on. I'm gonna go ahead and start by using the 3D polyline command because I have 3D points. Okay, I'm gonna repeat the same thing, I'm gonna connect to these lines. And these are all my concrete shots, so I'm using the concrete layer. Okay, perfect. And I know that this right here is an arc, so I'm actually going to convert these to an arc. It doesn't have to be perfect. I'm gonna create an arc here as well. Looks like this can be converted to an arc as well. Actually, I don't like this line over here, so I'm going to remove the vertices because I don't think it should be there. It does look like this needs to come here. C3, and it's as simple as that. I'm just gonna go ahead and connect up everything, and here's the final picture right here, so you can see what my final project looks like. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, be sure to like the video. I really appreciate it. Also subscribe if you're looking for more videos like this, and with that, I will see you guys next time.